We just got this new image in of an historic event at an equally historic location, a green-hued comet that has not been visible in the night sky since the Stone Age. That's about 50,000 years ago. It was recently photographed above Stonehenge in England. As close as the comet got to Earth, it was still a ways away, more than 100 times the distance to the moon. But it is a rare and historic treat to see it. I'm joined now by Adam Frank, professor of astrophysics at the University of Rochester. Professor Frank, thank you so much for being with us. How significant is this comet, and did you get a chance to see it yourself?
Well, the thing that's really cool about this is time, right? If you think of the comet as it goes around in its orbit as like a clock, then the last time that, you know, the hands were pointing to where it is now was the Ice Age, essentially, when there was, you know, 2 miles of ice above my head in Rochester, and the entire world's population could fit into Cleveland. So, you know, it's just, what this really shows us is these comets are visitors from, you know, the dawn of time in many ways. And it's just such an amazing thing to think about. You know, the last time this comet went by, it was all forests, and now it's, you know, New York City and TikTok. So the comet's probably pretty surprised.
Well, I missed it last time and this time, so now I have to wait another 50,000 years?
Well, actually, it's possible this comet, a comet like this, which is coming from very far out, like, you know, literally almost a light year away at the very edges of the solar system, it's possible this comet's going to leave, that actually interactions with Saturn or Jupiter are going to give it just enough energy that it's never coming back.
It was just discovered, and this is unusual also, it was just discovered last March. So how common is it to discover something that old?
Well, there's two kinds of comets. There's the ones that come around, you know, less than every 200 years, like Halley's. Every, you know, what is it? I think 75 years or so, Halley comes by. But these comets are so far out that really you only pretty much catch them once. You catch them the first time that they're coming in, because often they'll fall into the sun, or once they're gone, they're not coming back forever, or, you know, for 50,000 years. So it's this new telescope technology, amazing technology we have, that can pick up faint objects in the sky as they change position, you know, one night after the other. It's taking like pictures of the entire sky every night. So it's because of that transient telescope, we call that, that we're able to catch more of these. And soon we'll probably be catching a lot more of these intruders from the edge of the solar system.
I keep looking at the pictures because they're just stunning. We've got 30 seconds left. I understand the comet can be differentiated from the stars because it has that streaking tail of dust and energized particles around it, as well as something called a green coma surrounding it. What exactly is a coma in this context, and where does the green come from?
Yeah, so a comet is basically a giant mountain of mush, of frozen mush. And as it comes in towards the sun, it heats up. And as it heats up, the ices begin to melt and vaporize. And so the coma is sort of this gas and plasma that's surrounding the comet that just recently went from the ice state to the gaseous state. And the green comes from actually light from the sun ripping apart molecules like cyanide or carbons, that two carbon atoms that are glued together. And so it's that green hue is telling you that the surface of the comet is kind of being torn apart by the intense light from the sun.
Yeah, again, if you missed it this time, it may not exist in a few more years because it may get torn apart, so don't get upset. Professor, great to talk to you. Thank you very much for really helping us understand this marvel that we have seen.
It was a real pleasure. Thank you.